Back in April, I uploaded a trilogy of videos about the edgy short film I made in high school called Vincent and Dwayne Seek Vengeance. But unfortunately, that wasn't the only edgy short film I made in high school. Not even close. I've got dozens of these locked away in a vault of cringe and regret. And if I had any self-respect at all, they would never see the light of day. Luckily for all of you, my self-respect died the moment I put on a baby costume in the latest Wheel of Punishment. Which is why today, I'm going to discuss a short film I made in March of 2013 titled Mike Becomes Transgender. Just the title alone earns a 4 out of 5 on the oofometer. Now, in case it isn't obvious, I've always had an interest in playing edgy characters. Vincent the Atheist, of course, being the most infamous example. But now it's time to introduce you to a character that came out right around the same time. Mike the Southerner. Mike the Southerner has two character traits. One, he speaks with a thick southern accent that was inspired by Leonardo DiCaprio's character in Django Unchained. And two, he is always saying and doing the most offensive things possible. And real quick, before I start diving into the scenes of this film, you might remember that Vincent and Dwayne Seek Vengeance was created for the film club at my high school, and I showed it in a classroom full of students and teachers. Well, Mike Becomes Transgender was also premiered in this very same film club. So keep in mind that everything you're about to see was shown in a high school classroom as part of an extracurricular activity. Boy, I sure do hope somebody got fired for that blunder.
But it's like I always say, Clark, if the girl don't shave, I ain't going in the cave.
Mike, what are you talking about? I just asked you what was for lunch today.
Great. We've got more in-studio audience laughter. Thankfully, there's not much more after this. Then we meet a transgender character named Jamie, who you might recognize as God from the God and Jesus show. Mike assumes that Jamie must be gay, and his friend Clark teaches him an important lesson.
Yo, Clark, look! It's that gay Jamie kid!
Jamie isn't gay. She's transgender.
She? You mean he.
Keep in mind, this was made in 2013, long before transgender issues really hit the mainstream. I was truly ahead of my time, mostly because I went on 4chan every day and all they ever talked about were traps.
A transgender is someone trapped in the wrong gender. Although Jamie isn't a male's body, Jamie is a female, so we call her she.
That's the most retarded thing I've ever heard. If he's got a dick, then he's a he. I don't care what his psycho brain is telling him.
Again, this was made not only to be shown at school, but I'm literally filming it in school.
You can't keep getting away with it! He can't keep getting away with it!
Mike then sees Jamie walk into the girls' bathroom, and he's downright disgusted.
What the hell was that? He can just walk into the girls' bathroom because he thinks he's a girl?
The school could get sued for discrimination otherwise. But what's the harm? Jamie knows she's a female. So it wouldn't be right if she used the male's restroom.
What's the harm? The harm is that he... she... has a dick! Dicks don't belong in the girls' bathroom.
So that's why they don't let you in.
Okay. I've gotta admit, that joke still holds up pretty well. After about an hour of in-studio audience laughter, Mike evaluates the situation and comes up with a dastardly plan.
Hey, wait a minute. If I pretended I was one of these transgender freaks, then I could get into the girls' bathroom too. Yeah, and then I could sneak peeks at girls while they pee and whatnot. Mike, This just might be your smartest idea ever. All right, here we go. Into the girls' locker room.
All right, now I know what you're thinking.
But Mumkey, that's literally, word for word, the plot of the South Park episode, The Sissy, where Cartman pretends to be transgender so he can go in the girls' bathroom. You ripped off South Park, you unoriginal faggot!
Okay, listen, I get it. My short film is very, very similar to the South Park episode where Cartman does the same exact thing. And it even has some of the same jokes. Mike keeps mispronouncing the word transgender just like Cartman does.
Transgender freaks.
Because I'm transgender. I looked it up, that means I can use the girl's shitter.
The transgender transformation is just putting on a pink article of clothing. I understand that it seems like I copied South Park beat for beat on this one. Oh, wait a second. My video came out on March 8th, 2013, and the South Park episode came out on October 8th, 2014? A full 18 months later?
Uh-oh, Simpsons did it! Simpsons did it!
No! No!
Simpsons did it! Simpsons did it!
Yeah, well, Mumkey did it first this time, motherfuckers! Thanks for stealing my video, Matt and Trey! I know that you guys were one of the 1,512 views that the video originally got. I'll forgive you for blatantly stealing my video. As long as you contribute $30,000 to my Patreon within the next 48 hours. Otherwise, I'll see you motherfuckers in court!
Mike, what are you doing in here, you pervert? Get out!
Ladies, calm down. I'm one of them trans joker guys now. My brains tell me I have lady parts even though I don't.
Now, I don't have a sister to fuck. But if I did, she'd probably look like that. And I've gotta say, I think I like what I see. I wouldn't mind having some 11-toed babies with her if you catch my drift! I wanna fuck the girl version of me. So now you're probably wondering how I convinced 7 high school girls to be in my stupid video. Good question, good question. Oh, I don't have an answer. I have no idea how the fuck I did it.
Is that a camera? I'm getting the principal.
Whoa, 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 hold on. That would be discrimination. If I say I'm trans Jingleheimer, then I can use any bathroom or locker room that I want. Because my brain says so.
Mike, you idiot. You're not transgender. You're just a stupid perv. And even if you were, you have no right to bring a camera in here. I'm pretty sure bringing a camera in a locker room is against the law.
Alright, so that's a half-decent breaking the fourth wall joke. But I don't know why I decided to hold that shot for about 45 minutes too long. Boy, I sure do hope somebody got fired for that blunder. Now here's where the video gets a little, politically topsy-turvy. And what I mean by that is, the message of the film becomes trapped in a game of tug-of-war, where the characters give their opinions on transgender bathroom rights, and the film itself seems to paradoxically agree with these characters back and forth. And by the end of it, it's very, very confusing as to what message I was trying to give with the film. Let's watch.
I'm serious, girls. If you tell on me, then I'll sue.
This is just disgusting what you're doing. There are tens of thousands of people who identify themselves as transgender every year and get abused for it. It's not just the lifestyle, it's their life, it's who they are. And you're taking advantage of these people for your own personal gain. You are the worst kind of person.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now pose for a picture.
So, you want to be a girl now, huh?
Ha 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 ha! That might be the funniest reveal in any film I've ever made. But just wait until you hear who this character is.
Magic Ghost Wizard of the High School? What are you doing here?
So this is the Magic Ghost Wizard of the High School, who just might be one of my favorite characters of all time. Apparently, it's just accepted that the school is haunted by a magic ghost wizard, and it's so commonplace that nobody seems to react whatsoever. Mike is just curious as to why he's in the girls' locker room, and I've gotta admit, it's a bit redundant for the character's name to feature both the words magic and wizard. And in case you can't tell, this is Dwayne from Vincent and Dwayne Seek Vengeance.
So, if you want to be a girl, I'll make you a girl. Spell powers, activate!
Oh my god! It's gone! What have you done? Give it back!
I like how turning Mike into a real girl just meant taking his penis away and not changing his voice or giving him boobs. This whole scene is actually still really funny to me. But anyway, here's where the politics of the film really go all over the place. So I'll just play the rest of this political roller coaster without any interruptions.
I'll change you back on one condition. You have to admit they aren't really transgender and that you're doing this just to get attention. Like actual transgender people are.
Alright, fine. I was just pretending so that people would give me attention.
Wait, this is just horrible and wrong. This video is just offensive and wrong, and I quit.
Well, that's the movie. The lesson seems to be that transgender people are doing it just to get attention, and then this offensive moral is countered by the actress breaking character and storming out of the movie because it's too offensive. So, what lesson should we take away from this? I don't fucking know. Now, the lesser minds in the audience are going to ask, was that last scene scripted? In fact, when I uploaded this short film to my second channel back in January, I received multiple comments asking the same thing. So, instead of answering the question, let me ask you, what is more likely, that this was part of the script and serves as the final joke of the video, or that none of the girls in the scene read the script beforehand, and then we filmed the whole thing in order, and then I set up the perfect camera angle for the final shot, and then once we started filming, the girl broke character and stormed off, and then I decided to leave it in the video? That one really activates your almonds. Well, folks, that's just another episode in the cringe files that were my high school years. I wouldn't say this film is particularly funny, although it does have some good moments, and I am proud that I tackled this subject 18 months before a show that prides itself on being topical. But at the end of the day, was it worth wasting my free time making this garbage instead of studying, or going on dates, or playing sports? Probably not. I'm not even in contact with any of the people in the video anymore, so it's not like it was a bonding experience that created lifelong friends. I dedicated years of my life to making this shit, and all I have to show for it are horrible, cringy videos. At least in the modern day, I'm making money from doing this, and people are actually watching my videos now. And I have made some actual friends thanks to my video career. So if I could go back in time, would I do it all over again? Would I waste thousands of hours of my free time making shitty short films rather than doing something, perhaps, socially worthwhile? Well, I guess it depends on... If Matt and Trey give me my $30,000, you copycat motherfuckers!